As of July of 2013, 1.5 million new Android devices were being activated every day. So it's hard to believe that just a few years ago, I started all meetings with potential developers explaining what Android was and convincing them it was worth their time and effort developing for the platform. It wasn't until 2010 that we even shared numbers to indicate the growth of the platform, 100,000 daily activations in May of that year, which quickly grew to 500,000 in mid-2011 and crossed the 1 million daily activations mark in 2012. That represents over 1 billion Android devices around the world, which is why I don't start my presentations asking if anyone in the room has an Android device anymore. To me though, the biggest surprise in those early days was how much effort was required to convince people that developing for mobile at all was a worthwhile investment. A huge number of people use their phones to go online, and many of them use their phone as the main way to do so. One study by the Pew Research Internet Project in 2013 found that nearly two-thirds of mobile owners use their phones to go online, double the rate found in 2009, and that a third of phone users use mostly their phone to get online. Think about that for a second. These portable phones have become pocket computers constantly connected to the cloud to make the sum of human knowledge available to us at a touch and a glance. It's no wonder then that for a growing number of people, mobile isn't how to get online when you're away from your desk. It's actually displacing PCs as their primary computing platform. The change is so dramatic and the trend so clear that companies like Google, who depend entirely on the internet, have a mobile-first policy, ensuring that the mobile experience is the first consideration when building new products. This trend is particularly evident amongst younger users who grew up using mobiles, and especially in emerging markets like Africa and Asia, where the infrastructure to support ubiquitous broadband for desktops isn't as readily available. I saw this firsthand when I had the good fortune to visit Kenya a few years ago. The ubiquitous phones and passionate, talented developers were really familiar, but what really struck me was the degree to which mobile phones had become an integral part of people's everyday lives. It wasn't just checking email and posting to Facebook, it was using M-Pasa to buy everything from groceries to bus fare. Mobiles were such a part of life that I heard rather than buying someone a drink to show that you're interested, you'd send them phone credits so that they could call you if they felt the same way. And the transition of smartphones from tech accessory to a part of life, to the main way you get online, to how you pay for things, even how you flirt, represents a huge opportunity for us as developers. The question is, how are you going to change the world?